comes to trends, Kohler really is the leader when it comes to trends in the kitchen, the bathroom, and really what's hot now and how to translate it into each space. So, talking trends.
Well, they're actually listed right here behind us. This year, we are with white, pale, smoky, pattern, noir, and color. What we're gonna be doing is taking you guys through 6 vignettes over the next few minutes, and we're gonna tell you how we've incorporated these trends into some of these looks with some of the newest products.
Yeah.
So why don't we get started?
Follow us. We're gonna start here with this first vignette, which is one of my favorites. I feel like it's versatile. I think it's really masculine, but it still has this sexy edge to it. The colorway is nice and muted, but not boring. And so I think it plays into a couple different, you know, trends here. So we've got the white trend, right? The memoirs stands out next to this tile that has this beautiful beveled edge with the gray tone. So a little bit of the pale neutrals, right?
You guys should definitely feel the sculpting of some of these backsplashes.
And I love the fact that it really becomes kind of an art wall. And on that art wall, we bring in a little bit of a finish here.
Absolutely.
With the custom medicine mirror, the lighted Verdera mirror. And so then you've got a little bit of play with the ceramic, then the tile, we've got the white, and then we've got a little bit of wood. I feel like the memoir sink now with the new apron.
It kind of reinvents it all over again.
It's really beautiful,
does.
And it's clean, and I think the oil rub bronze finish with this gray and these wood tones works perfectly.
Yep.
The new memoirs wall hung toilet is actually my favorite in this vignette because it's more contemporary than the, you know, memoirs collection. I think go a little transitional, a little traditional, but now everything is off the floor.
I just love the cleanability with it. I mean, think about how easy it would be to clean this bathroom, right? It just makes it just like another thing. It's clean design, it looks beautiful, and is also very
practical.
And I
just keep saying I like that he wants to clean it. That's great.
I just said it's easily cleanable. You keep putting me into this.
Clean the bathroom.
Exactly. Okay, moving on. If we turn 90 degrees here, we're gonna see another vignette that brings in a couple of different trends. We see pattern, we definitely see the white trend here. We're mixing marble. It's a very, very popular look right now.
Well, and mixing marbles, listen, people get scared to start mixing. So this really plays into that pattern trend and not being afraid to play with pattern. So we've got the muted colors, the pale neutrals,
yep,
the grays with that kind of blush tone again, and then our standouts.
Well, so the specifics of this vignette that really are attractive to me are specifically the sink, this raised vessel. This is iron planes in basalt. It's beautiful, and I think that this has a lot of versatility with how it can be used.
Absolutely, right, and this now, is a trough sink. I mean, this is actually a trough sink elevated, so it's just beautiful in that basalt color.
That's right, we have this nice elevation here. This is a little bit reminiscent to the farmhouse style, honestly, in the bathroom. It throws us back to that same nostalgic feel. We're gonna be showing you guys a brand new release over in the kitchen area shortly, where we're showing the kitchen version of this same look and feel. We also have the Verdera mirror here. Again, just clean lines. Everything about this is just simple and classic,
yep,
but also edgy.
Absolutely, and playing into the blush tones, we're gonna head on over here to the blanched pastels. So one of my favorite vignettes. I feel like it's feminine, but it still has a masculine edge to it with the clean lines and the custom vanity and the cashmere color, the sink with the French gold faucet. I just feel like we're playing into those pale neutrals, but I love, love, love this wood tone. And the fact that, again, we're customizing it with the wood trim around the mirrors and the French gold accents throughout.
And you could buy this all together. It looks so custom, but the fact that we can get the same finish, the same sheen, the same wood variety, it looks like it all goes together.
And again, a little pattern play, but keeping in those tones with the blush colors and this beautiful herringbone pattern with a nice muted floor. And that's it. I mean,
this
when it
really
comes to the gold, I love gold. So anywhere you can use it, use it.
And really, this color combination with the vessel and the gold, even with the drain, is beautiful.
Well, listen, gray isn't going anywhere, right? Last year, I feel like it was the new neutral, and it's here to stay. And the fact that we're playing with it and mixing metals, this is the perfect vignette to
do it in. Well, speaking of gray and many other colors, if we turn around 180 degrees, we're going to see color and pattern in a big way. A
lot of pattern in the background.
A lot of pattern. Now, you might think, wow, this is very, very edgy, and it is. But oh, you're good. Please, by all means.
Pictures.
She's actually checking out the sartorial sink, which is a very beautiful thing to behold. If you come up close, you can actually see the textural there's actually a three-dimensionality to the texture here. We have a herringbone pattern on the black here, and we have a paisley pattern here. Just a beautiful art piece, especially when you get up close. A lot of the vessels that you're gonna see this year have an immense amount of pattern and intrigue to them. So they're an art piece all their own, but you experience them within the scale of how you interact with the function and the utility of the sink itself. We have, again, more lighted mirrors here. Again, a little bit understated.
Understated with the pattern, right? It's a big pattern in the back. But then really playing into that noir, right? That smoky noir with the pinstripe faucet in the matte black. And I just think, you know, with a little bit of pattern play here in the sink, you see it, but you don't. So we definitely urge you to come on up, take a look, take a feel. But we are going to be heading into the new Veil collection.
This one's so beautiful. It combines tech, it combines beauty, and new techniques for manufacturing.
Listen, lighting is key, right, Chip? I mean, I think about it every day when I design, so do you. I feel like it's one of the most important things to think about when it's, you know, coming time to design your bathroom.
You almost look like me before you have good light.
Yeah.
And then it's amazing.
Listen, lighting can change everything. Sometimes I get ready in the morning, I think I look great, I walk out, I look like a clown, right? So we know how important lighting is and getting it right, and now you get to control it all with this remote. Okay, so some of us like warmer lighting, and some of us like a little cooler lighting. So you can control the light here with this remote to bring it to a nice cool state. And then we can also control the light by dimming it down or increasing it with the touch of a button.
This is your own personal setting. So even motion control, as you enter the bathroom,
yeah,
you can program it to come on at the color temperature that you are connecting most with.
And think about like in the morning, right? We don't want it to be too aggressive. We're just waking up. We kind of want to ease into our day. So maybe it's a little bit warmer. I tend to go a little bit on the warmer side, and that's really going to ease me into my morning. So to have that sensor to be able to walk right into my bathroom and all of a sudden the lights are on to where I've set them, and I can dim them. I mean, that to me is customization, and that's key in this new bathroom. So
one thing I really love about the connectivity with the lighting is it actually becomes an element that ties everything together in the bathroom. You notice the drain, the halo around the bottom of the tub, even the toilet. We can turn it back on, and we can see how this actually connects it all together and eliminates the necessity for stereotypical lighting like sconces, overheads, to be able to get that task lighting that's a necessity in the
Absolutely.
Bathroom.
Absolutely, and as a designer, we're always thinking about, do we want a light bar? Do we want sconces? You know, you really want to be able to maybe highlight your backsplash or your wallpaper. So this takes that guesswork away, and you've got lighting incorporated right into it. And now you talk about just the Veil line in general with this thin edge, but still substantial. So it really does look like a piece of art. It's organic. I think it's just, it's almost like a piece of art right smack in the middle of your bathroom. So whether it's the freestanding pedestal sink, whether it's the toilet, or the new vessels, and we'll be showing you another vessel when we do the next tour on the outside, a larger version of it. But I just think it really is an art piece.
And don't overlook the black and brass together, just
oh,
absolutely
I always
beautiful.
Forget about that, and that is my favorite combo. My powder room is black, and it's brass. And so this combo, I hope it never goes anywhere. But again, you're really allowing that to shine and having the lighting incorporated right into the actual pieces.